Well, it's the first Monday of the month, October, here we come. And those of you who watch regularly will know that that's a Mary Berryday. Here she is indeed. Hello, Mary. Welcome to the programme again. Now, we're going to be doing more recipes today from your Good Afternoon Cookery book. And what are they based on today?
The cheaper cuts of meat. And interesting ways to use them.
Good. Well, you're fiddling or whatever you're doing with that short crust pastry. So what's that for?
This is for Slade's pie. And Slade's pie is a large Cornish pasty without all the work of rolling out, say, six little rings of pastry. You just make one big one, which is much easier to make.
Why Slade's? Why that name?
Well, we go to a farm in Devon for our holiday, and Mrs. Slade makes this pie for our supper.
What a logical reason for calling it Slade's
pie. Well, you know, I think she's sometimes cooking for about 16 people. You can't mess about making little tiny Cornish pasties.
No. So this short crust pastry...
This is the basic short crust pastry, Judy, and I'm using 12 ounces of plain flour and 6 ounces of fat. And I use half lard and half cheap margarine. And so that's 12 ounces of flour and 6 ounces of fat. Mm. And I've rubbed it in. They will say like fine breadcrumbs. And then to the water. And I haven't added the water because that's the important part. I'm going to add 3 tablespoonfuls of water. And I've found that if people measure the water, you really will get good results. That's 1, 2, 3.
That's the most essential part of that.
It is. For each 4 ounces of flour, add 1 tablespoonful of water, and you won't go far wrong. Mm. And then just work it together. I think people are inclined, I know I am if I'm not thinking, to add too much water to bring it together. And it's much better to add at this amount of water, and you'll get a good result every time. Mm. Just enough not to give a cracking edge. There we are. And you just go on mixing until it all gathers together. You see, I've got a lump now, and it's going to be just get the rest from the edge of the bowl.
Well.
Mm. Short crust is the easiest pastry to make out of all the pastries, and I think it's the nicest. There we are. Just let it cling together. All the way
so
around
one
the outside.
Tablespoonful of water for every 4 ounces of flour that you
That's
use.
Right.
That's
and then
a good maxim.
I usually, from choice, if I'm having sort of a baking morning, I would first of all make the pastry and then I would put it in the fridge to chill before rolling it out.
For not too long, I would...
Well, half an hour, and then that just lets it rest. Mm. There we are. Now we've got a nice clean bowl, Judy, and it's finished.
Good.
I haven't quite got flour up my arms, but I seem to have got it past my knuckles. Mrs. Beaton wouldn't have been proud of me, would she? There we are. And so that is now made and just needs to be perhaps wrapped in transparent film and put in the fridge. I've already started this recipe, and I've rolled 2/3 of the same amount out to line a 7x8 tin. It's just an ordinary tin, but it must be deep enough to take the filling. So about 7x11 or 7x10. And I've lined the dish, and then I'm going to fill it with the usual Cornish pasty filling. And I'm going to make some of the ingredients optional because in Cornwall I gather that they don't like carrot in it. I'm putting carrot in, so it's not quite authentic. I've got 1 pound of mince, and this will serve 6, so it's making 1 pound of minced beef serve 6.
It's and lean, that, isn't it?
It must be lean. And Mrs. Slade sometimes doesn't use mince. She uses finely chopped meat, which is I find quite difficult to do, and it's much easier to use mince. Then I'm going to add carrot, about 4 ounces of carrot. That's about that size. That's why I left it sort of half a big one. 6 ounces of potato. All these ingredients are raw. And a large onion.
Those are all chopped up.
All chopped up.
Small pieces.
And they just want to be mixed well together. Mm. Now you need plenty of seasoning to this. At least 1.5 teaspoonfuls of salt.
I suppose each ingredient needs its own salt anyway, and you've got to allow for...
You're quite right. It really does need to be well seasoned. And lots of pepper. I like it freshly ground. Mm.
I think as you were explaining to me, in fact, when you'd cook meat, you'd put the salt in. When you put the carrots, you'd have salt in, and so on for each one. So that's why it absorbs quite a lot, doesn't it, with them all mixed together?
There we are. Mm. Work it well down, and then tip it into the already lined tin, and that's with 2/3 of the pastry. I I often do this, Judy, on the draining board at home because I always seem to manage to tip. You know, you tip something out of a big bowl, a few pieces go on the floor and I find myself treading round. So I pop this on the draining board and we're away. There we are. It just fills it, you see?
Yes. That's why it's necessary to have the right size of tin, obviously.
And now to the lid. Brush any bits away. Right. I nearly put it in the salt. There we are. Just sprinkle the board with flour and that's a third ready for the top. Well floured.
Can you freeze this if you made it, if you were having a cooking day? I mean, would it all freeze?
Yes, I would freeze it before cooking it and then take it from the freezer and cook it later. Bit more flour. The kitchen's quite warm today. You notice I flour the rolling pin and I flour the board. I don't flour the pastry. And you can just see the edge of the pastry is just cracking slightly. That's a sign of good pastry. You see all the way around the edge, there's a slight crack. And this was well rested before I rolled it. And it's quite all right to even make the pastry the day before, but you need to have it out at room temperature before...
Before you roll it?
Yes.
Otherwise it's too dry, isn't it?
There we are. Just a bit bigger than the actual thing. So to make the two stick together, just brush the top with a little milk or water. I'm going to use milk because I'm going to be making it shiny on top. There we are. And then to lift it over, it helps to pop it on top of the rolling pin, like that.
Ah, that's how you do it, is it?
It should be about the right size. And it should be a bit bigger. That's lucky, isn't it? There we are. And to take the outside, just push it down a bit. That's right. And then take a knife and chop it off all round. Now this one's got a tight lip at the top. Be careful not to chop my arm off on the way round. That's right, move it round.
You always do make these things look so easy.
Well, you have it at a slight slant, the knife. And then, you see, at a slant, like that. And then it allows for a little tiny bit of shrinkage. There we are. Press it down. And then to decorate it, you just pinch it all the way around, like this. Everybody pinches it differently.
Do they?
Well, they do. I push with this first finger. Some people do it with their thumb. And it isn't only for decoration. As I'm doing it, I'm pressing it down onto the lip. And then pressing it down onto the lip makes it stick. And then it won't shrink. This is if the children are helping you, let them go around with a fork. Otherwise they'll put their whole fingers right the way down, unless they're the older ones. Then if you wish, you can decorate it with leaves, or you could use this little bit of pastry for a small few jam tarts. Then to glaze it, I only use milk. It's, there's no need to break an egg specially.
And that just gives it the shine.
That's right. And then that's all ready for baking.
Lovely. And how long does it take to bake?
This is important. You want to bake it in a hot oven to begin with. That's 425. Gas number 7, and that's to set the pastry and to brown it for about 20 minutes. And remember, we've got ordinary mince in it, so we want to lower the temperature to 350, gas number 4, for a further 35 minutes to cook the meat.
Because that takes good slow cooking, doesn't it?
That's right. Then that wants to go into the oven now, and I've already got one cooked. Now, I'm not actually putting it into the oven. I'm going to collect the one that is cooked, because there we are.
Good.
That's right. This is one keeping hot. This is under the grill. There we are, Judy.
Very good.
That's what it looks like. And I decorated this one with leaves. Would you like to have a look inside?
Yes, why not? Trouble is, you know, when I look inside, I want to have a nibble.
Here we are, that lovely juicy...
Oh, it's super.
There we are, pop it back. Well,